was that God and unveiled as thy Lord, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Glory to the holy consubstantial life-giving and divine Trinity, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Out and not forth my eyes from you, Father. I pray unto thee, O Lord, the Holy Long, I stretch out. humble man lied in humble suit, but by you gave him an exalted to a humble mind of distress. Thy fury should pass upon me, thy fear is a sorely troubled. They came around me about like water all day long, they come to see that together. Now it should be far from me, friend and neighbor, my acquaintance, because of my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day I cry, and by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down in thy ear with my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and depend on all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, and thy youth shall be renewed as the evils. The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all that are wrong. He hath made his way to know unto Moses and the sons of Israel the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not at the end will he be angered, neither unto eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven put the earth, the Lord has made his mercy prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon the Son, so hath the Lord had compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth forever we are made, he hath remembered them in your dust. As for man, his days are as the grass, as the flower of the field, so shall he cross the forth. For when witness passed over it, then shall be God and wonderful in one's place thereof. But the verse of the Lord is from eternity, even out of eternity, upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons of sons, upon them that he was tested and remembers the commandments. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne and his completed ruler over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, mind and strength, and perform his word, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers, and hear his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, and every place that is in me, bless the Lord, my soul. And every place that is in me, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication and my surety. Hearken unto me in my righteousness. And enter not into judgment with thy servant, for thy sight shall not have been in judgment time. But the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat me in darkness as those that have long been dead, and my spirit within me is become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old, I meditated on all thy works, and pondered of the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul lives and after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for thee I live my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way where I should walk, for to thee I lift up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness. For thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou quicken me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction. And in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me to the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and into ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, God. O our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Who by now let our sin.
From the peace, for the peace from above and salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
In the whole world, the good state of the holy churches of God and the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and those who have faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the Honorable Presbytery, the Diaconate in Christ, all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President, civil authorities, and armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and every city, city and countryside and faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord. For healthful seasons, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, the sick and the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious Saint Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us again and again in peace. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Saints, Let us commend ourselves to each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Sing, O Lord.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Together with the Father, and also the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, blessed of those never-virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commit ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Now, Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But when Thomas said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and place my fingers in the mark of the nails, and place my hand in his side, I will not believe." 8 days later, the disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. The doors were shut, but Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be to you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, and see my hands, and put out your hand and place it in my side. Do not be faithless, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are not written in this book, but these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life. In his name.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
In that we behold the resurrection of Christ, let us bow down before the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. Thy cross to be a door of Christ, and thy holy resurrection be praised and glorified, for thou art our God, and we know none other beside thee. We call upon thy name. O come, all ye faithful, let us adore Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, the cross is joy coming to all the world, ever blessing the Lord. Let us sing his resurrection, for in that he endured the cross for us. He has destroyed death by death.
Have mercy
on me,
O God, according to thy great mercy, according to the multitude of thy compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me purely from my iniquity, cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, my sin is ever before me. Against thee only, thy sin is ever before me.
Exalt the poor Orthodox Christians, and send out upon us thy rich mercies through the intercessions of our all-immaculate Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, by the light of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable body of his powers of heaven, At the supplication of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all laudable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers, along with the saints, great hierarchs, and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Trimethus, and Nectarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers in law and the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrius the Merce, Dreamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the martyr martyrs, Ignatius the god bearer of Antioch, Paranamos, and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women, Martin, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fotini, Marina, Paris, Kiva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy, righteous, of the holy and righteous Joseph, the betrothed, David the prophet and king, and James the brother of God, Virgin Martyr Anicia of Thessalonica, Martyr Theteros of Nicomedia, Venerable Leon the Archimandrite, Venerable Martyr Gideon of Caracalla, Monastery on Athos, Athos, and Macarius, Metropolitan of Moscow, whose memory we celebrate today, the Ball of the Saints, who beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy,
Lord, have mercy.
Although Joseph was of the royal lineage,
carpenter of Nazareth. At the age of 80, Joseph took the most holy virgin from the temple of Jerusalem and into his home. He entered into rest at the age of 110. The apostle James is called the brother of the Lord, because he was the son of the righteous Joseph and chosen. James greatly loved Jesus, and according to tradition, he traveled to Egypt with the most holy virgin and Joseph, when Herod sought to slay the newborn king. By the holy intercessions, O God, have mercy upon us and save us. Amen.
For he hath regarded holiness as animated
is kept without the imagination of a bitter heart.
More honorable than this ever been, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Thou who without sin bearest on the word, and God truly fails, so most be magnified.
Is the Lord our God. Thank you.
virgin hearts you proclaimed, and through them thou hast granted thy peace unto the civilized world. O thou who all of earth quenches in mercy.
Bless, Master. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and to ages of ages.
To the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Now.
again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in true remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed, and glorious, Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Receive it from man, nor was I taught it, but it came through revelation of Jesus Christ. For you have heard of my former life in Judaism, how I persecuted the Church of God violently and tried to destroy it. And I advanced in Judaism beyond many of my own age among my people. So extremely zealous was I for the traditions of my fathers. But when he who had set me apart before I was born and had called me through his grace was pleased to reveal his son to me in order that I might preach him among the Gentiles. I did not confer with flesh and blood, nor did I go up to Jerusalem to those who were apostles before me, but I went away into Arabia, and again I returned to Damascus. Then after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to visit Cephas and remained with him 15 days, but I saw none other apostles except for James, the Lord's brother.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Wisdom. 10. Let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to thee, O Lord. Glory to thee, O Lord.
Let us attend.
When the wise men had departed, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, Rise, take the child and his mother, and flee to Egypt and remain there until I tell you. For Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him. And he rose and took the child and his mother by night and departed to Egypt and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet, Out of Egypt have I called my son. Then Herod, when he saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, was in a furious rage. And he sent and killed all the male children in Bethlehem, in all the region who were 2 years old or under, according to the time which he had ascertained from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what was spoken by the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing in loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they were no more. But when Herod died, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt, saying, Rise, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who sought the child's life are dead. And he rose and took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus reigned over Judea, in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there, and being warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and dwelt in a city called Nazareth, that what was spoken by the prophets might be fulfilled. He shall be called a Nazarene.
Christ is born.
Glory.
Isn't this a beautiful time of year? So much joy. We celebrate the nativity of our God. He took on our human flesh, came to earth as a baby, and dwelt among us that we could know him and be forgiven of our sins. We do special decorations. We have family time and meals, and we give gifts to those we love. Now, if you take a close look at the church calendar, you will notice that right after we celebrate the Nativity, we start having some commemorations of some really difficult things that happened in our church history. On the 27th, we have the first martyr, Stephen. We read about him in the book of Acts, how he was stoned for his faith. On the 28th, the 20,000 martyrs, 20,000 in Nicomedia in the 4th century, who refused to sacrifice to idols, and they were burned in a church. And then yesterday, we read about the 14,000 holy innocents is what the deacon just read. It was the gospel reading for today when Herod was trying to kill the baby Jesus. And he sent and slayed all the boys under the age of 2. What is the church trying to tell us? amidst our joy, we are called to keep in mind that the path is not an easy one. We should never rest as though safe in virginity. We celebrate, but we remain, as it were, battle ready. Let me share a story that illustrates this. I recently had the good fortune to take a little vacation to Prague in Germany. So Wendy and I took our boys, Dave and Johnny, and Wendy's mom, Marilyn Gilchrist, went with us. And if you've ever been to Europe, it's just beautiful. And, you know, cobblestone streets and churches and castles and everything's hundreds of years old. It's just wonderful and good food. But in the midst of our vacationing, we also wanted to take some sober moments. And, you know, for example, when we'd go visit a church, we would stop and pray, you know, not just ooh and ah over the beautiful statues and ceilings, but, you know, pray. That's what a church is for, after all. And on Sunday there, we visited St. Cyril and Methodius Orthodox Cathedral. It's a beautiful church. It's 300 or 400 years old. And it happens to have some really dramatic history. I was reading this history, this backstory to my mother-in-law before we visited. And in World War II, as Hitler was rolling through Europe, one of his very top leaders was stationed in Prague. And some Czech soldiers parachuted into Prague, and they were able to actually assassinate this guy. And this was far and away the most dramatic and the highest ranking assassination that occurred, period, in World War II. And Hitler, as you can imagine, was furious. And an unprecedented manhunt was launched to try to capture these guys who did. The soldiers were able to hide out, going from house to house for a few days in the underground resistance. They realized that wasn't going to work very well. I mean, there were just thousands of German soldiers just, you know, pulling people out of houses and trying to find these guys. So it's actually some Orthodox people, of all things, the head of the parish council of this St. Cyril and Methodius Church, he came up with this idea. He said, you know, we've got a crypt underneath the church. We can hide these 7 or 8 soldiers underneath, you know, in the crypt. And the bishop agreed to it. And so they did that. And it worked well for a couple, 3 weeks. But eventually somebody betrayed their position. And 900 Nazi soldiers surrounded the church. Big gun battle. And eventually the guys, you know, they didn't want to be taken alive, and so they either didn't cyanide capsules or use their last bullet so that they wouldn't be taken alive. And I was reading this history to Wendy's mom, and that's a tough enough part to read, but then the very next sentence said, and then they arrested the bishop, the head of the parish council, his wife, some choir people, some even youth. They took them out in a field and shot them. And it you know, struck me how we take so much for granted. And I was, something rolled through my head. You know, we just had a parish council election here. C.J. Metz, you know, C.J., when you volunteered to be on parish council, I don't know, I'm pretty sure it didn't cross your mind that potentially could be a life and death decision. Or, you know, Megan, you know, C.J.'s wife, it maybe didn't cross her mind that potentially could be a life and death decision. And, you know, Linda Decker, Bruce, Armin, Richard Moore, we've had a lot of people serve. And, you know, there is a serious side to our faith. The path sometimes is difficult. Now, I realize, brothers and sisters, that's a pretty dramatic example. And it's probably not something that we will actually end up facing. Now, there are some people currently, Christians in America, that are facing some tough persecution. You know, there's this cake baker in Colorado, this elderly florist lady in Seattle that are being, you know, sued and threatened with fines, financial ruin, even jail time, just for simply politely declining to not offer their services for a same-sex wedding. And, you know, their cases are going all the way to the Supreme Court, and it's not done yet. There have been some preliminary judgments, but it's not done. So that is potential, but I would even say it's even more often in the mundane, where we really struggle versus the dramatic. You know, this is, the day-to-day stuff is really where we slug it out and work on our salvation. You know, Father Hopko said, I love his quote, if not with a spear, at least with a sneer. So, you know, maybe we don't give our life at the hands of for martyrdom, but at least we can die to ourselves, right? And what did Jesus tell us? The Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. And he said, if you want to follow me, you take up your cross daily. And that was never one of my favorite scriptures. But what does this mean for us here today? How do we keep our joy, but remember that the path is not an easy one? Maybe you're frustrated with a spouse. Maybe you're frustrated you don't have a spouse. Maybe getting married just hasn't worked out for you yet. Maybe you're frustrated with your kids. I don't mean to be looking at you, Dean John. I know your kids are perfect. Kids, maybe you're frustrated with your parents. You know, they're so strict. You know, the Robinson twins, your mom drags you off to church, makes you do your homework, all these things. Maybe you're wrestling with an addiction of porn, drugs, alcohol. We can face and deal with these struggles with patience and kindness and love, both for ourselves and for those around us that might be struggling if it's not us. We don't want to enable, we don't look the other way when a situation needs help, but we do always love. A good example of this, I've got a good friend, and it's just come to light very recently that he's been hiding an addiction for years, a drug addiction, from his wife and kids. And speaking to the wife recently, she just handled this so beautifully, where she said, first of all, she did the tough love thing. She made him move out, and she insisted he go to rehab. But she said, I know that's not my husband. And she wasn't giving him a free pass. She knew correctly that the drug had taken so much control that he no longer had control. And sometimes that's the case. So I just, you know, want to qualify that we love, but sometimes love is tough. Now, even those few examples have some drama. I want to take it down even another notch to even more mundane. Maybe we walk the difficult path by helping make Eucharist bread. You know, Diane Reagan's in charge of that ministry. I saw her bringing the loaves in last night. Maybe you help. Maybe we help Michelle with the beautiful flowers. Maybe we attend a men's meeting, a women's meeting, a youth group meeting, even when we don't feel like going. Maybe we just suck it up and go anyway. Maybe we offer a kind word instead of a backbite. Maybe we help at a church work party, or even the ultimate, we join the choir. You know, I was thinking during the Nativity service, you know, hey, starting at 10 o'clock at night's tough, especially the older you get. But I was sitting back there, the first hour was pretty tough, 10 or 11 o'clock, I was really struggling. And at one point I looked up at Yumi leading the choir, and she was just in the zone, totally focused. And I thought, how does she do this? You know, it's midnight, how does she do this? And that's just one microcosm. You know, she is here early for almost every service. And she prepares before the service, you know, figures out the music and does rehearsals. And then tries to train, you know, third grade people like me that don't sing very well. But just so much effort. And then she drags her husband and her daughter to church early as well, and her parents. Yubi's parents, how are you doing? But it's a beautiful thing. But there's a lot of sacrifice. All of these examples require effort and sacrifice, but they all have elements of joy. I don't want to just focus on the sacrifice. We can rejoice and celebrate beautiful flowers. We can rejoice and celebrate the heavenly choir singing and how that helps lead us in our worship. We can celebrate and have joy in family victories. Even in well-baked bread, we can have joy. So brothers and sisters, in this Nativity season, let us keep our abundant joy of our God taking on our human flesh. But let us also be battle-ready and remember that the path is not an easy one to the glory of God the Father. Christ is born.
Thank you.
Wayne, for Donald and Gloria, for Wanda, Aaron, Teresa, and their families, for Nadia, for the Deacon Chris, for Bradley, Sean, and for Christine, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Lord,
grant this soul, Lord.
Father, we remember and sorrow,
adopted Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thy all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Upon us, both manifest and unseen. we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands. Even though this hand assigned thee thousands of archangels and then thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six winged many eyes soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
people here present, those whom they are remembering, and of all mankind. Of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Calling to remembrance all the saints again and again in Jesus, let us pray to the Lord. Gifts which have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God who loveth mankind, receiving that upon his holy heavenly idea of altar for the odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in eternity's divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Holy things are for the holy. O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly Christ, the Son of the living God, who is come into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the chief. And I believe this is truly thine own immaculate body, and that this is truly thine own precious blood. Wherefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions. O voluntary and involuntary, of word and deed, of knowledge and ignorance, and make me worthy to partake of thy congregation, of thine immaculate mysteries, and to petition my sins, and to find my last. Amen. Of thy mystery suffer, Son of God, accept these days of communion, for I have not seen thy mystery to thy enemies. Neither will I give thee a testament to Jesus, but I give thee like my necessity. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom, not in thy judgment, nor in thy condemnation. Be my heart as a young man, and as you see, O Lord, but it's not to be Jesus also.
Thank you.
God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Let us pray to the Lord.
grace and love towards mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner at Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all-laudable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy and righteous Joseph, the betrothed, David, the prophet and king, and James, the brother of God, the Virgin Mother, Martyr Anicia of Thessalonica, and the martyr of Philaterios of Nicomedia, the Venerable Leon the Archimandrite, and the Venerable Gideon of Caracalu Monastery on Athos, and Macarius, Metropolitan of Moscow, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, and mercy upon us to save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. With the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.